Welcome to the very first episode of the Think Filter Show. We are very proud to present this show and the first episode of how India developed its very first indigenously designed and developed aircraft carrier, the IAC Vikrant. Why India developing and designing this aircraft carrier indigenously is such a big deal? Well, all the other or the previous aircraft carriers used by the Indian Navy were either British or Russian made. Only 5 or 6 countries globally have capacity and capability of developing or achieving such a feat. And now India has joined this elite club. Experts and other Navy officials say that by this demonstration, India has shown the capability and self-reliance of achieving such a momentous engineering feat, which is considered to be one of the most complex battleships in the world. Now let's dive a little deeper and get to know some interesting facts about this ship. The name Vikrant in Sanskrit means courageous, and the motto of this ship is Jayema Samayuddhi Spardha, that is, I defeat those who fight against me. Its maiden 5-day voyage were conducted in August of 2021, exactly 50 years of its predecessor INS Vikrant playing a massive role in the 1971 Bangladesh Liberation War. This aircraft carrier was handed over to the Indian Navy during India's 75th Independence Day, that is 15th August 2021. Now let's take a look to the timeline of how this massive project unfolded. In 1999, Project P-71 to build an air defense ship, ADS, was cleared. In 2003, the aircraft carrier project gets government nod. In 2006, the Navy changed the ADS, that is air defense ship, to an indigenous aircraft carrier. In 2009, the keel was laid. In 2011, the ship was floated out of dry dock. And in 2013, it was launched. In the November of 2020, the harbor and sea basin trials were conducted. And finally, in August of 2021, the maiden 5-day voyage was undertaken. Now let's understand some technical details of this ship. The weight of this massive ship is a whopping 45,000 tons. And it is made with a total budget of about 23,000 crores. It has a top speed of 28 knots. That is about 52 kilometers per hour, and a cruising speed of around 18 knots, that is almost 35 kilometers per hour. And its endurance, that is the gap after which it needs to be refueled, is almost 7,500 nautical miles. This massive ship is about 262 meters in length, 62 meters in width, and almost 60 meters in height. And it has 14 decks. It has 2,300 compartments for 1,700 crew members and specialized cabins for female officers. The ship was made at the Cochin shipyard, in which almost 550 companies were involved, out of which 100 were medium and small enterprises. A heartiest congratulations and salute to all these engineers. According to the Navy, almost 76% of the material used in the ship is indigenous. This includes 23,000 tons of steel, 2,500 kilometers of electric cables, almost 150 kilometers of pipes, and 2,000 valves. Apart from these, there is a wide range of finished goods used in the ship, like the air conditioning and refrigeration units, the steering gear, the rigid hull boats, and other galley equipment. Vikrant is powered by 4 General Electric LM2500 plus gas turbines on 2 shafts, generating almost 80 megawatts, that is 110,000 horsepower. Now let's understand which aircrafts can this massive aircraft carrier hold. Primarily, it will hold about 30 aircrafts, out of which maximum will be the MiG-29 fighter jets and some Kamov-31 helicopters. it is also expected that the newly launched Seahawk multi-role helicopters designed by American company Lockheed Martin will be used on these aircraft carriers. Apart from these, the ISE Vikrant can also hold advanced light helicopters designed and built by Bangalore-based HAL, that is Hindustan Aeronautics Limited. What does this development mean for the capabilities of the Indian Navy? In the words of the Chief Naval Staff, Admiral Karambir Singh, when he spoke during a press conference on board ISE Vikrant, he mentioned, there are two main roles performed by any Navy. One is denial of entry to the enemy in your own waters. That is mainly done by the submarines. And second is controlling the seas. And ISE Vikrant provides the Indian Navy the capability to control the situation in the sea. Now, what this statement means is that the Indian Navy, as well as the Indian leadership, can or do have the freedom to control operations or carry out operations which are in India's interest along in the high seas, anywhere around the globe. This news of India developing its first indigenous aircraft carrier had a very personal appeal for me. Because back in 2005, during my first job interview, during one of the group discussions, I was asked the question about what was my opinion about the state of Indian engineering. At that time, a fresh graduate, hot blood, I said that I was ashamed as a mechanical engineer that my country had to import its defense capabilities. But since then, India has developed its first aircraft carrier, that is ISE Vikrant, and we have developed our very first fighter jet as well, the Tejas. So certainly we are on the right track. This is an absolutely momentous achievement for Indian engineers. This just shows that engineers in this country, provided with proper focus, leadership, and direction, can achieve almost anything. Jai Hind.